love about this time of year is I feel like it's a time that we consider that miracles exist, that they can actually happen. You hear a lot about Christmas miracles. And we become more hopeful during this time of year. I mean, we're celebrating a miracle. If you think about it, over 2,000 years ago, that birth where the Son of God descended and was born of a virgin mother. And the shepherds were watching their flocks by night. And then an angel appears unto them and says, "Fear not, for behold, I bring unto you good tidings of great joy, for unto you is born this day a Savior." And then a choir of angels appear and start singing praises. Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, goodwill to men. And isn't it interesting that this announcement, it didn't happen to kings of countries or any like big political figures. It happened to shepherds, simple shepherds watching their sheep. And I think that says something about miracles. And you know, the shepherds, they make haste to go to see, the new star appears, and they go to see this baby Jesus. And we hear these stories and think, well, these are stories, or that happened a long time ago. Or, you know, miracles, they happen, maybe they happen, but not in my life. I've never seen a miracle, we may think. But, or you may wonder, well, how do you see miracles? You know, how can I experience miracles? And what is the purpose of miracles? I think it's to give us hope in something more. And to increase our belief in something that's greater than us. And I think if you've wondered this, if you felt like miracles aren't possible for you, I hope you can think when Christmas comes that it's a reminder to you that Christmas is a miracle for each of us. Because if you think about it, why are we still celebrating it 2,000 years later? The Son of God came, he lived, he suffered, and he died for each of you and for me. He's a Prince of Peace. He brings healing in his wings. He can forgive the sinner and the imperfect. And so we may wonder, well, how do we get a hold of that peace and that healing? I think it goes back to remembering. And if any of you wonder that and question if that Christmas can really be a miracle for you, I would say just remember him. Because in the very thought of him is what brings that spirit of Christmas to us. And as we think of him and ponder over him and that whole event and the purpose of it, in subtle ways, we'll start seeing more clearly and start gaining access to those miracles in our lives. So this next song we're going to sing, Luke chapter 2, it talks about the mother Mary and how she, as all these things were going on, she kept them in her heart and pondered over them. And she's probably wondering, what is about to happen in the life of this baby? The baby who's in my arms right now. And so as we ask her a question in this song, we want you to just keep these things in your heart and ponder over them as well. So here we go.
Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you've delivered will soon deliver you. Baby, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Baby, did you know that your baby boy will calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? As you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. Praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? The sleeping child you're holding is the grave.